evening. This is Lynda Cromar, and as you can see, I'm going to share some do's and don'ts of Periscope, kind of how you can completely maximize your Periscope just by following some of these rules. And I'll give you all of these in detail. So how are you all doing today? If I can get this to switch over, it's not doing it. There we go. Good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. And I wanted to share with you some ideas that I have found that is actually very, very helpful for me. And as you can tell, Periscope is a little bit different animal than any of the other of the social networks that we've been in part of in the past. It's a little bit like Twitter, but even a little bit different as well. Because of the fact, for instance, that we can't really share links, but there are ways actually that we can monetize in a different sort of way. And I'm going to share some ideas with you. For instance, first of all, let me go through the whole list here that I have here so that you can get the full content. Thanks for joining, and thanks so much for the hearts. I'm loving it. I've got over 50,000 so far. Thanks for joining. Anyway, our do's and don'ts for Periscope. I'm going to share what I've learned as I've started to use it that can help you. One thing that's really important, and I'm not seeing it on everybody, and maybe it wasn't a big deal in Twitter, but I think it really is in Periscope, and that is to have your own personal picture of yourself. Because if you think about it, it's all about engagement, it's all about attraction. And if you want people to come to your videos, which is what a Periscope is, you want them to see who you are. And your own profile, the picture and the description, are all going to have some of the information they need to know. What is it that's going to make them want to come and listen to what you have to say? So do have a picture. And I've always said that if you've followed me in Facebook ever, I always say that in Facebook too. It's so important. I see so many people that are actually using pictures of logos, or sometimes they don't even put up a picture at all. And the same default that happens with Twitter also happens with Periscope. And that is that you just get that funny little zero egg thing instead of your actual personal profile. And I'm not seeing your comments. I'm not sure why. It's kind of below the screen. Oh, here we go. Maybe it'll do it now. But for sure. And you can definitely put in your comments and questions. I definitely will respond. There was a couple of people that were probably saying something, but I didn't catch it. Yes, yes, yes. It's so important to actually have your picture. And what's really cool about Periscope is that your hearts will match your profile, and there's a little shading that happens to all of your pictures. Yeah, we've got quite a few people that are actually brand new connecting with each other. Now, second is give absolutely good content. In other words, you want to give something that you think is of value to them. And in this case, of course, I'm doing a Periscope, giving you some do's and don'ts. I'm not talking about my company or my product unless it's in the title. And then if you do that and you say you're going to do a demo or you're going to explain something, that's great. But make sure that your title matches the content that you're going to give as well, because that's really important. And then also engage. You want the talk, you want to have the comments, and you want to have the hearts. And if the person is coming back commenting, you want to make sure and mention that to them. So I appreciate all your comments. I didn't see one that was actually a question, but I do appreciate all of it. And I do appreciate the hearts as well. And then also follow and engage with all of other people's Periscopes. One thing I started doing is I've been going into the ones that have followed me so far. How do you get hearts? The person taps the screen repeatedly, and that creates the hearts. The faster you do it, the more hearts that come up. And it accumulates on, oh, we'll see you later then. Great. I appreciate you coming. You actually tap the screen repeatedly, very, very fast. And that creates a lot of hearts. There you go. And then engagement. Engagement on Periscope is all about comments, sharing the Periscope. So everybody that shares, I will definitely go back and do that for you, even if you have a recorded one. That is really important. Share everybody's Periscope. If they're giving good stuff, share it. And the way you do that is for an iPhone, you swipe to the right, and for an Android, you swipe up, and it gives you a who's here, and it also, yes, nice to meet you also. It gives you absolutely, it gives you where you can share. You can share it on Twitter. You can share it to the people that you're connected to here. Engagement is really important. Yes, absolutely, I agree with you. What is your first name? I see your username. I don't see the name always, unless it's in your username. I don't see your name. But anyway, swipe to the right or swipe up to share, and that is really something that's nice to do. Hello, Kendra, how are you? And it's very nice to do that for other people. I've been doing that a lot today. And when, yes, you can do it also in the replays. Yes, thank you, Penny or Richard. Yes, absolutely, you can do that. And that really helps. And I appreciate how everybody helps each other also in this Periscope. How long have I been on Periscope? Just about a little past 2 weeks. And I have almost 2,000 follows, which is really kind of cool. But I think that also comes from because I've been very, very active in here. And I actually try to go to everybody else's Periscopes. I listen and I give them feedback as well. How do I get 2,000? I'm giving you some ideas on how that can happen. You want to use a good smiling face. You want to give good content. You want to engagement, and then absolutely you want to. Oh, absolutely, you sing every morning. That's pretty cool. I'll have to check that out. And then you want to follow back whenever they follow you. The only ones I don't particularly like to follow is the ones that don't bother to put up their picture and they're still an egg, because then that doesn't help me know who they are. And so make sure you have a picture. And then you want to give a good, strong call to action at least once in your Periscope. And what do I mean by a call to action? In other words, we can't actually give somebody a link, but we can give them a place to go. You're in Queensland. Oh, that's awesome. Over in down under in Australia then, right? Yeah, you don't automatic. No, we don't have automatic follow back with Periscope, at least not at this point. So you have to do it personally yourself, and that's very, very useful, and also a call to action. And what I mean by a call to action is that you absolutely must have something that they can do to connect with you, or some way that they can get more information. Or I always tell them at least where my Facebook is or some other thing like that. Now, here's some don'ts that I'm going to share that will help also. Don't always expect them to always follow you, but you're not going to give anything back. In other words, you're not going to follow, you're not going to go over to their Periscopes, you're not going to do any engagement at all. If you're only going to make them come to you, but you're not going to do anything for them, you're going to get people that are going to unfollow, and that's not good too. Only follow those who always follow you. In other words, just staying in your own little niche and your own little group of people and not venturing out. Well, you're not going to get very many people that are new, and obviously, you're looking for new prospects in this new social media. Well, that's your own choice. You can do that if you don't want to follow people. But you know what? If you don't follow people, obviously they're not going to follow you. And if you don't do that, I follow back people that I want to. I don't mean that you don't ever not do it, but I look at them, I check them out, and then I decide. And there's some that I have decided not to follow because I didn't like their content or some of the things they were doing. And you do have that choice. Be consistent with your involvement on this social media. Just like anything else, consistency is absolutely paramount. If you're going to want to create a real following that actually wants to know about your content and wants to check it out every time that you offer it, don't make inappropriate comments that are kind of derogatory, and you only want people to follow you that like your topic. Well, that's possibly true if they're in your niche, obviously, but you're also looking for people that are new, that are not necessarily people that you've been connected with before. So how do you know yet? You don't. And you don't want to be always pitching your deal when you're in somebody else's Periscope, unless it's specifically asking you to do that. Like, there's been some I've been on where they say, "What do you do? I'm going to have you all tell. What do you do?" And if you do that, then of course, that's something that you can do. Yes, promoting people, that's a really good Periscope, and actually you can get quite a bit of engagement with that one, obviously. So that's a really good one. So let me recap. Your do's are use a very good picture of yourself so that people can actually share and see who you are. It helps them get a little bit better idea of who you are if you're using your own picture instead of maybe a cat or a dog or a symbol of some sort. It's better to use your own picture. You want to give good content that you really do feel is of value to you. And you want to engage on Periscope every single day. And you also want to do Periscopes every single day. Now, a lot of people haven't done them yet, but you know what I told somebody recently in another Periscope is to just go do it. The more you do it, the more comfortable you're going to get, and you don't have to make them long. I would absolutely just say I'm going to give one or two tips about something. Do it at least once a day. That's exactly right. And if you're doing that, then it will be of use to you and it will help you a lot. And I like how everybody's interacting and helping each other. That's really great. And then also make sure and give a real strong call to action that will help that person get better acquainted with who you are. Yeah, you could actually delete any Periscopes you're not happy with, and then probably nobody's going to even see them if you get them quickly. You would have to delete also the post in Twitter because mine is already set up to go directly to Twitter. So obviously, you'd have to go there and delete it as well if you have something that you really don't want people to see. But these are when you hit the button for starting the broadcast, they're immediate. They're not where you have a time period where it's kind of sitting there. So you want to make sure that you're really ready to go. And then on the don'ts, expect them to always follow you and if you don't give back. Now, somebody said they never follow, but you do need to go and follow some of them, or you're not going to increase your following itself at all. And then only follow those who you're always following. In other words, if you've got just a little group of people you like to always follow, that's great. But if you don't follow anybody else, how do you expect to increase your following? And then be inconsistent with your involvement. You don't want to be inconsistent with your following. Your involvement on this social media. This is probably not a place to try to do once a week. There are some things where you do once a week and that works, but this is not one of them. And make inappropriate comments. For instance, if somebody, I had somebody at the very beginning when I did my very first one, which of course wasn't perfect to start with. And he was making comments about how I looked and stuff like that. I don't think that's necessarily important to do that. I think you can hurt people's feelings, and there's really no reason why you have to do that. If you don't like how somebody looks, you don't have to stay on their Periscope. You can leave at any time. Nobody is forcing you to stay there. And then don't be pitching your deal unless it's something where they're asking you to tell what you do. And there are Periscopes I have been on. Yeah, I dislike trolls too. I've only had one, and of course I blocked him. And did you know that you can actually block them right inside of this Periscope right now? If you were doing one, you can actually click on one of their comments, and you can actually go and it'll show you the option of being able to block them. And how do you change your name? That is not something I know for sure about. I know you have to do it with Periscope and Twitter, but there supposedly is a way, but I don't know. I always use my name because it's real easy, and then it's real easy for people to find me. If you want targeted viewers, join a promotion scope. Yes, absolutely. That is a really good way to get more targeted followers. Absolutely. It's a really good way. So that's what I have to share with you. I wanted to make sure that you had the opportunity to see that list again. So I'm going to give you one more kind of recap. Use a good personal picture, smiling picture of yourself. Give good content. Do a Periscope daily. Engage on other Periscopes. Follow and follow back. Give a call to action. In other words, give them places where they can find you so that they can learn more. And I thought I lost it. And then, finally, I'm going to also give you my own call to action. And this is my Facebook page right here. This is actually the About Me. And I'm going to share with you that there are ways that you can connect with me as well. That first link up there is my newsletter, in which I actually give you about 3 ebooks that help you make money. And I also have an actual training for Periscope that really has helped me build my 2,000 followers. And you can definitely get that from me. And follow me back at Facebook, and that is at Lynda Cromar. Where it is? Lynda Cromar with a number 1 behind it. And I have enjoyed talking to you today, and I will be coming back tomorrow. See you then.